It's trending on Facebook. A lab at your favorite university developed a new drug that will reduce your risk of developing a disease by 50%. Everyone's talking about it. But is 50% the risk you should really care about? The thing about the media is, they desperately want to survive, and they want to catch your attention. The risks they report on are often technically true, but they are not really the numbers you need to make an informed decision about your life. Let's take a disease. Canadian liver disease. It's not a real thing, just run with it. A pharmaceutical company is releasing a new daily pill to help prevent Canadian liver disease in patients who are at risk, including you. So you take this pill every day and your odds of developing the disease go down. How much down? This is your normal risk of developing this disease if your doctor says that you are at risk. With the pill, your risk decreases like so. As you can see, this is a 50% reduction in risk. Journalists, news anchors, people on Twitter, everyone is spreading the word. This drug reduces your risk of developing Canadian liver disease by 50%. This is huge. And they're not lying to you, technically. But here's what's happening. This 50% is a relative risk. It's a comparison between two risks, one in which you take the pill and one in which you don't. The question you need to ask yourself is, what is my absolute risk of developing Canadian liver disease? Here's what they're not showing you. The yellow bricks are a scale from 1 to 100. Your absolute risk of developing Canadian liver disease without the drug is 2%. Your absolute risk of developing the disease with the drug is 1%. The difference between the two is indeed 50%. 1% is one half of 2%, so the difference is 50%. But when you know that you're actually going from a 2% risk, which is not very high, to a 1% risk, you're in a much better position to make an informed decision about whether or not to take this pill. Once again, this is the relative risk the media are always quoting. These are the absolute risks the media rarely show you because they're not sexy. And this 50% relative risk that is so quotable is true for many different scenarios. If your absolute risk goes from 10% to 5%, but also if it goes from 0.1% to 0.05%. The absolute risk informs you on how likely something is to occur, whereas the relative risk, on its own, does not. By quoting relative risk and keeping mum on absolute risk, the media, the scientists, and pharmaceutical companies dramatize the situation to catch your eye. Don't be deceived. Always look for absolute risk. Meanwhile, your absolute risk of regretting liking this video is close to 0%, so why don't you give us a like? Hey, did you like the video? Would you like to see more? Subscribe to our channel, The Body of Evidence, and go to our website as well. This is how you help us get famous.